This program is brought to you by realestate.com.au. With more homes for sale than anywhere else, realestate.com.au is Australia's number one address in property.
Welcome back. Let's take a look at the weekend's auction results. Across the country, there were just under 1,600 auctions, the clearance rate coming in at 61.3%. That's a big jump in the clearance rate from last week's 56.9%. In Sydney, there were 614 auctions with a clearance rate of 65.8%. Across New South Wales, there are also 1,626 private sales. In Melbourne, there were 478 auctions with a clearance rate of 61.5%. In Victoria, there were also 1,083 private sales. In Brisbane, there were 76 auctions with a clearance rate of 67.1%. And across Queensland, there were a further 1,057 private sales. In Adelaide, there were 79 auctions with a clearance rate of 87.3%. plus a further 228 private sales across South Australia. In Perth, there were just three properties scheduled to go to auction. They didn't sell, but across Western Australia, 521 homes were sold by private treaty. For more on property, I spoke with Anne Flaherty from REA Group a little earlier.
They certainly are holding up pretty well. We've seen a really good clearance rate over the weekend, and I think this comes down to there still being a lot of buyers out there looking. At the same time, of course, over winter, we don't see as many properties come up for sale. So it looks like that buyer demand is really meeting that supply.
Any regions around Australia doing better than others right now?
Well, look, Western Australia is absolutely the best performing property market right now. We've seen the strongest property price growth. We've seen the strongest rent growth. It's where population growth is outpacing anywhere in the country. And actually, we've seen a really strong rise in the number of property investors looking in Western Australia. So we've actually seen a lot more people searching. So year on year, there's, I think, 50% more loans to property investors in Western Australia compared to the same time last year.
Yeah, you mentioned that lending indicators numbers came out today from the Bureau of Statistics, and really looking at the past 12 months, you've really seen a growth really in loans for both investors and for owner-occupiers as well.
That's right. We've seen loans up across the board. We've seen about a 5% rise for first home buyers, about a 6% rise for subsequent home buyers, but it's really the investors that have seen the strongest rise, up about 25% increase in the number of new loans. And the biggest rise anywhere in the country, as I mentioned, was WA. Also seeing really strong rises in places like New South Wales and South Australia.
Yeah, what do you think's getting investors excited again about putting their money back into property? What's really boosting confidence in that sector?
Look, if you think about the underlying fundamentals of Australia's property market, we have staggering population growth, particularly compared to a lot of other countries in the world. At the same time, we know that the population is outpacing the speed at which we're building new homes. So we're going to have a situation where that demand for housing is going to continue to outpace supply for a number of years. And if you look at the rent growth that we've also seen, what we're seeing is investment yields as well are making a comeback. So long-term capital growth prospects are really positive, increasing rental yields. There's a lot to draw investors to the market at the moment.
Yeah, I know last week REA Group, you put out a property price report for the month of June, but what's the outlook for national prices over the rest of this year?
Look, we do expect property prices to continue to rise. The extent to which they do rise, I think, is going to be impacted by other factors, such as if we do see another interest rate rise. I think if that was to happen, that could be a blow to confidence. That might cause some people to delay buying until they're a little sure exactly how far interest rates, if they go up again, or, you know, how much longer they're going to have to wait until they come down again. But overall, you know, the reality with real estate is people need somewhere to live. And until that changes, we're not going to really see any sort of significant downwards movement in home prices, particularly against a backdrop of, as I mentioned, that population growth exceeding the speed at which we build new housing.
Well, Anne Flaherty from REA Group, thanks for coming on the show this afternoon.
Thanks for having me.